What sort of honey do you want to go for?
I'm too embarrassed.
Oh, is she with him?
I mean, I'm too embarrassed to tell you.
What? Why is that?
I like Tesco's. Really dirty stuff. I mean the prison stripe stuff.
That's all right.
Really?
Of course.
I'm not putting honest, hard-working beekeepers out of business.
I wouldn't have thought so, no.
Do you think I'm a honey philistine?
Some of the supermarket stuff's all right.
Really?
Some of it's fine, yeah.
Don't take this the wrong way, or
go on.
Do you make a living?
I do, yeah.
I mean from beekeeping.
From beekeeping, yeah.
Wow, how does it work?
Well, I used to work for a friend of mine in Wiltshire.
Very nice.
But one day I decided I wanted to go into business by myself. But my ex-girlfriend...
I'm sorry for your loss.
What's that?
No, I mean it was just a joke.
Right.
You know, as in, sorry for your loss.
Right.
It's just a joke.
No. So she, my ex, she wanted to move to London, so we got this one bed place in Tower Hamlets.
Oh, no wonder you broke up with her. I would have broken up with her too if she made me live in Wiltshire in fucking Tower Hamlets.
Oh. I'm still living there, actually.
Lovely curries.
We didn't have enough room for bees.
I see.
We didn't have a garden.
Bummer.
So one day, I was up on the roof, and I realised it was perfect. So I tied it up a bit, and I got my first hive.
Amazing.
And I went from one to two, from two to four. We went away, me and Laura, we went to Spain, and when we got back, we found that the flat had been raided.
Raided?
I used to keep the honey in bin bags. You know those black plastic bin liners?
Yes.
I didn't have a lot of money at the time, and the bin bags were just a cheap alternative. And when we were away, one of the neighbours must have called the police. Thought I was brewing up smack or something. And they probably went for it, the police. They kicked in the front door, they turned the flat upside down, and they confiscated all of these bin bags filled with the most amazing honey and honeycomb.
Did that really happen?
Yeah.
You used to keep honey in bin bags.
Yeah.
Roland, I don't think I can go back to work.
Have they told you?
They're great.
Have you told them then?
Not yet.
But you're going to?
I think so.
But you haven't said any of this to them?
They've said whatever I want.
So what about part-time?
I don't know the point.
You mean the point of going part-time?
Either I'm walking or... I either do it or I don't. It scares me.
Work?
Stopping.
Stopping work scares you?
What will I do?
Well, go away. We can do whatever
you want.
I don't. I'm being serious.
I don't.
I mean it.
I don't. We can't. I have to. Have to make a. I have to have a choice. Control.
You want me to leave?
Not in a bad way, but yeah.
Have I done something wrong?
No.
Have I said something? Have I offended you?
No.
I thought we had a nice evening.
We did.
Coming back here was your suggestion.
I know, but on reflection...
Do you want to come inside, you say?
I know, but now I've changed my mind. I mean, I'm allowed to change my mind, aren't I?
If I'm allowed to ask why, sure.
I'd just rather not get into it.
Can you at least tell me if it's me?
I'm
not saying specifically, just generally speaking.
I'm just going through some things at the moment. And you're right. We did have a really lovely evening. And you're right. It was my idea to come back here, but I just... As soon as we stepped aside, I just started thinking.
You want me to leave?
Not in a bad way, but yeah.
Have I done something wrong?
No.
Have I said something? Have I offended you?
No.
Well, then I don't understand.
I'm not asking you to understand. I'm asking you to leave.
Well, that's a bit fucking rich, isn't it?
I'm sorry.
This was your idea.
Charming.
Just saying.
Okay.
It's rude.
Yeah, I'd like you to leave now.
Ooh, I should probably head back.
You don't. I mean, don't feel you have to.
I've got a really early start, so...
yeah. How early is early?
6.
You could. I mean, not in like a welcome to my lair kind of way. But if you wanted to, you could stay.
I should probably head back. Yeah.
Well, thanks for a really enjoyable evening.
Likewise.
We should. I mean, when you're free.
Definitely. Yeah.
The lair thing was just a joke, by the way.
Come again?
I mean, Sophie just falls out. You wouldn't have to stay in my bed. Oh, stop talking, Marianne. Not in a bad way, but yeah.
Have I done something wrong?
No.
Have I said something? Have I offended you?
No.
I thought we had a nice evening.
We did.
Coming back here was your suggestion.
No, but on reflection, it's just not.
Do you want to come inside? You said.
I know, but now I've changed my mind. I'm allowed to change my mind, aren't I? Just rather not to get into it.
I went on another date a couple of weeks ago and almost exactly the same thing happened, so look, I'm more than happy to leave you to it, but if it is me...
It's not.
I'm not saying you have to be specific.
It's not you.
Do you have some feedback?
Feedback?
Feedback's not right. What I mean is...
Okay, I'm just going through some things at the moment. My mother... She's been ill for a really long time. And I can't tell whether or not I want you to stay because I want you to stay. Or whether or not I just don't want to go to sleep on my own.
I'm really sorry.
Why don't we just speak in a week or so?
A friend of mine said to me when I told him I was going on a date, he said, what does she do?
What did you say?
I said I don't really know, but I think it's something to do with space. And when we were talking about your job earlier on, I was nodding along the entire time, but when we stepped inside your front door, I realised I hadn't understood a single thing you'd said.
Most of my time is spent sitting in front of a computer.
Right.
Inputting data.
Right.
Cosmic microwave background readings.
Okay.
Radiation left over from the Big Bang.
Right.
Cosmology. Theoretical early universe cosmology.
I said I don't really know, but I think it's something to do with space. And when we were talking about your job earlier on, I was nodding along the entire time, but when we stepped in your front door, I realised I hadn't understood a single thing you'd said.
Most of my time is spent sitting in front of the computer.
Right.
Inputting data.
Right.
Quantum cosmology?
Okay.
Do you know much about theoretical physics?
Pass.
Quantum mechanics?
Pass.
Quantum mechanics focuses on the quantum realm. Atoms, molecules, on nuclear and atomic scales, gravity is pretty much insignificant. But, in terms of general relativity, it's vital. So you have these two theories, which are completely at odds with one another. Relativity covers the sun, the moon, the stars, while quantum mechanics takes care of molecules, atoms, quarks, that sort of thing. We've effectively asked the same question twice and come up with two completely different answers.
This is really sexy, by the way.
The point being...
I had an amazing time tonight, and I'd really like to spend the night.
But?
With you. I'd really like to spend the night.
But then you've got string theory. Or, to be a bit more specific, you've got lots and lots of different string theories.
If you'd rather I didn't stay, you just have to say.
And that's exciting. And the exciting thing about string theory is it potentially bridges a gap between relativity and quantum mechanics.
You haven't answered either of my questions.
A byproduct of every single one of these theories, almost entirely by accident, is the possibility that we're part of a multiverse. Despite our best efforts, there are certain microscopic observations that cannot be predicted absolutely. Now, potentially, one way of explaining this is to draw the conclusion that, at any given moment, several outcomes can coexist simultaneously.
This is genuinely turning me on.
In the quantum multiverse, every choice, every decision you've ever and never made exists in an unimaginably vast ensemble of parallel universes.
Everything I've ever done.
Everything you've ever and never done. You should try and keep our voices down. My housemate might hear us.
If everything I'm ever going to do already exists, then what's the point in me even, do you see what I'm saying?
No, totally. But let's just say that ours really is the only universe that exists. Well, then there's only one unique me and one unique you. If that were true, then there could only ever really be one choice. But if every possible future exists, then the decisions we do and don't make will determine which one of these futures we actually end up experiencing. I mean, imagine rolling a dice 6,000 times.
Everything. Everything I'm ever going to do.
Everything you ever and never going to do. We should try and keep our voices but
if everything I'm ever going to do already exists, then what's the point in it?
There isn't.
What?
In none of our equations do we see any sign whatsoever of any evidence of free will.
In your equations?
We're just particles.
Oh, speak for yourself.
You, me, everyone, we might think we have some say, we might think we have some say in the way things play out. But we're just particles. Particles governed by a series of very particular laws, being knocked the fuck around all over the place.
You make it sound so glamorous.
Most of my time is spent sitting in front of the computer, typing up numbers. It's not really very interesting.
Okay.
Look, I had a really enjoyable evening.
No, yeah, me.
I haven't really made up my mind, though, whether or not I'd like you to stay. I've just got quite a bit on at the moment. We were having a really enjoyable evening, and I thought it would be really nice to invite you back, but I just want to be clear that I'm not massively interested in sleeping with you.
Yeah, I mean, that's...
I just kind of rather get into bed and go to sleep. But I'm completely happy to go get you a sleeping bag and a couple of towels.
Okay.
Oh. But just to be clear, I'm not being coy. I'm not sort of saying no to sex and yes to all the other stuff. We're going to go to sleep separately, and then we're going to wake up and we're going to have some toast. Or, I mean, whatever. We don't have to have toast.
The floor's fine, honestly.
I'm so tired. I'm so tired, Roland. Before people had face. Before they had face. Face. Before they... Fuck.
Okay.
God.
God.
People's lives were their own. Before it became skin. Skin. It became... Skin.
Skin?
Mum wasn't scared of dying. She was scared of being kept alive. You know?
Yeah.
It wasn't what scared her.
I understand.
It's not just speaking.
Okay, no, I don't understand.
BD. I'm having trouble. Numbers. Words. On the page. I don't know how to explain it. Typing. Typing as well.
In what way?
I know the word I'm trying to type. But I don't know the letters. None of the letters seem right.
Wait. Don't need to finish.
I want to.
I think I know what you're trying to say.
How? How can you know what I'm trying to say? Most of the time, I don't even know what I'm trying to say.
Well, I was being polite because I don't want you to weigh yourself out.
Maybe you should just get me a notepad to hang around my neck.
What?
Kitty.
Very fucking hell.
Roland, I don't think I can go back to work.
Alright.
Where have you been?
Oh.
I sent you a text.
I know.
Well, why didn't you text me back?
Don't know.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I don't know. It means I didn't think it was urgent.
Well, I didn't know where you were.
I just told you.
Now? You just told me now, but I wanted to know before.
I was playing tennis. I was playing tennis with Tony, and then we went to the pub. What's wrong? What is it?
Roland, I'm really sorry.
What? What is it?
James and I had sex.
James?
From work.
Centre party? You mean the bloke with the centre party?
Yes.
When?
There's been a few times, actually.
How many's a few?
I'd rather not get...
How many's a few, Mary?
Six. Maybe seven.
Spread out? Were there six or seven times spread out over a particular period of time?
Yes.
Are you together then? Do you want to be together?
I don't know.
Is he moving in?
Of course not, Roland. Of course he's not moving in.
Do you want me to move out? When do you want me to move out?
There's no rush.
That's it then, is it? Alright.
Where have you been?
Oh.
I sent you a text.
I know.
And why didn't you text me back?
I don't know.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I don't know. It means I didn't think it was urgent.
Well, I didn't know where you were.
I just told you.
Now? You just told me now, but I wanted to know before.
I was playing tennis. I was playing tennis with Tony, and then we went to the pub. What's wrong? What is it?
Oh, Roland, I'm really sorry. James and I had sex.
James?
From work.
Dandruff?
No.
You mean the point with the dandruff?
Yes.
When?
There's been a few times,
well,
actually.
A few.
I'd rather not...
How many is a few, Mary?
Maybe seven.
Spread out?
What?
Were the six or seven times you had sex spread out over a particular period of time?
Yes.
Are you together then? Do you want to be together?
I don't know.
Is he moving in? Oh, when do you want me to move out?
There's no rush.
How old is he?
24.
24?
Yes.
He's a child.
He's 24, Roland.
Where'd you have sex?
All sorts of places.
What does that mean?
It means we've had sex in more than one place.
Here?
No.
Oh.
Of course not here,
yeah.
Roland.
His place?
Yes.
Where's he live?
Brighton.
You have sex in the daytime then?
Yes.
In the fucking daytime?
I mean, sometimes, yes.
Or during lunch, is it? So when's he moving in, Mary? When's he going to...
There's no particular day.
But he is going to move in.
Hopefully.
Am I boring?
What?
Do I bore you?
No.
We don't talk about space enough, is that it?
It's got nothing to do with work.
Well, that doesn't make it better, you know? Because if you'd said yes, it's because we don't talk about space enough, it might have made a bit more sense. I'd kick myself for not making more of an effort, but at least it would make a bit more sense.
Oh, there's no linear explanation, I'm afraid.
Where have you been?
Work.
I sent you a text.
I know.
Well, you've not texted me back.
I know.
Well, what does that mean?
It means I know you sent me a text.
I didn't know where you were.
I was at work. Hey, why are you being so touchy? I was at work. It was the 7:37 and then the 8:04 didn't turn up. What's wrong?
Mary, I'm really sorry, but I had sex with Alison O'Connor Tuesday the week before last.
Alison O'Connor?
Yeah.
I thought she was going bald.
What?
She's going fucking bald, Roland. How many times?
Once? Yeah, Tuesday the week before last.
What were you doing? I mean, what were the two of you doing?
I was helping her set up a hive.
Is this a fucking joke?
No.
You were helping her set up a fucking hive?
Yeah.
Speak up.
Yes, I was helping her set up a hive.
Is it serious?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I need some time to think about it.
Oh, you need some time to think about it?
Preferably, yeah.
Does this mean you're moving out?
That's up to you, really.
If it were up to me, Roland, you wouldn't have fucked fucking Alison O'Connor.
All right!
Excuse me?
Calm down.
Fuck you, actually. I've never been happier. Living with you? Just so you know.
Well, that doesn't make it easier, you know? Because if you said yes, because we don't talk about space enough, it might have made a bit more sense. I'd kick myself for not making more of an effort, but at least it would make a bit more sense.
There's no straightforward explanation, I'm afraid.
Don't make me leave.
Roman, come on.
This is the best fucking thing that's ever happened to me. I'm serious.
No, you'll be fine.
I don't know what I'm going
to
do.
You can move back to Tower Hamlets.
Is that meant to be a joke?
No. I'm just saying there's lots. Look, there's lots you can do.
I don't care.
Come on.
I don't!
You'll be fine. Come on. You're being melodramatic.
How long have you been waiting to tell me?
A week.
I was going to propose.
Roland.
I need some time to...
You need some time to think about it.
Preferably, yeah.
Does this mean you're moving out?
Well, that's up to you, really.
It's not up to me, Roland. You wouldn't have fucked fucking Alison O'Connor.
All right!
Excuse me?
I don't want to fight.
Tough.
What?
I said tough.
Mary, come on, I'm telling you because I regret
it. You regret something once. You don't regret it and keep going.
What's the likelihood that you might be able to forgive me?
Where have you been?
Pub.
I sent you a text.
I know.
Why didn't you text me back?
Don't know.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I don't know. It means I didn't think it was urgent.
I didn't know where you were.
I just told you.
Now? You just told me now, but I wanted to know before.
I was playing tennis with Tony, and then we went to the pool. What's wrong?
Roland, I'm really sorry.
What? What is it?
James and I had sex. Roland, did
you... I know!
What?
You had a message from me while you were in the shower. I read it.
Yeah, you need to leave.
Make me.
What?
I said make me.
I keep thinking of one.
In what way?
Well, she died.
Right.
And she said she didn't want any more food.
Yeah. I'm not sure we ever really talked about it.
I thought we did.
Bits and pieces, maybe.
She said she wanted them to stop the IV. Should we talk about that?
I think maybe we did, yeah.
They asked me to leave. I went back the next day and she was starting to look like a ghost. It takes an enormous amount of strength. And like that. To keep going. I'm not sure I have it.
You don't know. You don't know that.
Thinking.
Mary,
okay.
Listen to me.
I'm so tired. I'm so tired, Roland.
Hello, Marianne. Something to do with the XMM cluster survey?
Wow, that's really amazing, Roman.
What do you think of the honey?
It was delicious. It was completely delicious. Are you here for the ballroom club?
Yeah, I am. Yeah.
Really?
Oh, Heather's getting married in a couple of months, so...
Oh, to the PE teacher.
What's that?
He was a PE teacher, wasn't he?
Right. No, I see. Ooh, no, they called it a day. New bloke is a something or other for the Office of National Statistics. I've been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else. How about you? Do you...
Oh, similar, really. Wedding.
Oh. Your own, or...?
No. Mine. Yeah.
Oh. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Is your fiancé...
He's been held up. He's been held up.
Hello, Marianne. It's Roland.
Roland?
How are you? Oh, I hope I didn't scare you a bit.
No, I mean a bit, yeah. A bit, actually.
Sorry.
Are you here for the ballroom class?
Yeah, I am.
Ballroom, really?
Heather's getting married, so...
Heather?
My sister.
Of course.
I've been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else.
Did you know that I was going to be here?
What?
Did you know that I was going to be here?
No. No, of course not.
I'm only boring because I'm getting married, Roland.
No, sure.
In September.
Congratulations.
Thank you. How about you? Are you...
I was, but for the moment, no.
Married?
Seeing someone. I was seeing someone, but we broke up, so...
I'm sorry.
No, please, don't. Don't be. How's it going?
Good. I'm really good.
Great. That's really great.
I bought some of your honey.
Really?
Yeah, from the Budgeons in Crouch End.
Yeah, right.
I said to the girl on the till, I said I used to know the man who made that honey.
What'd she say?
She just stared at me. How's business going?
Yeah, good. I mean, great. We're about to start doing pollen.
Pollen?
Yes, you scrape it off the legs of the bees, and then you ground it down. It's really good for you, apparently.
Scraping the legs off bees or pollen?
Had an offer from Tesco, of all people.
For the pollen?
No, just the honey.
Well, how much for?
Fair whack.
And what did you say?
I told them to go fuck themselves. I read one of your papers.
You did not?
I did. I downloaded it.
Oh, which one did you read?
Oh, it was something to do with, like, hot sub-dwarf stars?
Were you really looking for midget porn on Google?
What's that?
Sub-dwarfs? It was a
joke. Gotcha. What did you think of the honey?
It was delicious. It was completely delicious.
It's heaven.
Yes.
We cart the bees up to the heather moors every August, one by one.
One by one?
Hives, not bees.
Are you here for the ballroom?
Yeah, no. Yeah, I am.
Really?
Yeah. I'm actually engaged.
Oh, wow!
So, yeah.
Who's the lucky lady?
Alison? Alison,
I remember.
How about you?
You know, just trying to lose a little bit of weight. Too many late night digestive binges. And then sub-dwarfs, the stars, the paper you read.
Heather is getting married in a couple of months, so...
Oh, is it a PE teacher?
What?
He was a PE teacher.
Right,
wasn't he?
No, I see. They call it a day. New bloke is a something or other for the DVLA.
Wow.
I've been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else. How about you? Are you...
Similar, really. Wedding.
Oh, you your own, or...?
God, no. Can you imagine? I'm being a very diligent bridesmaid. But having some kind of mass feelings warmth. I'm not sure I fully understand it yet.
So is this your first lesson?
No, second. How about you?
First, yeah.
Well done with the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work last week and the crotch was like a fucking furnace by the time I was
Mary, I'm really sorry.
Well done on the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work last week. Crotch was like a fucking inferno by the time I got home. Roland, I'm really sorry.
What for?
Well done on the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work last week. Crotch was like a fucking sore by the time I got home. Otherwise, I'm going to feel like a complete fraud.
Mary.
Why don't we go for a drink? I don't know what I'm doing here anyway. One drink, and if you never want to see me again, you never have to see me again.
Mary!
Why don't we go for a drink? I don't know what I'm doing here anyway. One drink, and if you never want to see me again, you never have to see me again.
Mary!
One drink, and if you never want to see me again. never want to see me again, you'll never have to see me again.
Mary!
You never want to see me again!
Say.
You don't have to say anything.
No, I know, but I want to. I want to know what to say to you.
A lot of people apparently never go through with that.
How do you mean?
A lot of people. Once they've been given the green light. Night. Once they've... A lot of...
It's okay.
They're happy enough knowing it's there.
How do you know that?
It's on the website.
When you say a lot, how many are we talking?
I think it was something like 2/3. Safety net. For a lot of people.
And is that how you're feeling about it?
I don't know.
Would I be able to come with you?
I'm going to speak to Martin. Would you want to? Come with me.
Would you want me to come with you?
I keep thinking of mine.
There are 3 different kinds of bees. The drones,
Roland.
The workers, and a single solitary queen. The workers are all women. Their job is to forage for honey, pollen, etc. Their lifespan is potentially anywhere between 5 weeks and 6 months, and then they die. Drones exist solely to have sex with the queen. Each hive tends to have around 100 drones. Once they've deposited their sperm, their penis gets ripped off, and they die. Honeybees have an unfailing clarity of purpose. Their lives are often intentionally short.
In
a strange sort of way, I'm jealous of the humble honeybee and their quiet elegance. If only our existence were that simple. If only we could understand why it is that we're here and what it is we're meant to spend our lives doing. I am uncertain when it comes to a great many things, but there is now one thing I am defiantly certain of. Marry Annabelle, will you marry me?
Roland, I have got to do a tutorial. I mean, you can't just turn up like this. It's the middle of the afternoon. There's a lot going on. I need to think about this. I'm sorry. I just really need some space.
All right.
Wow, this is a surprise.
Is it?
I mean, it's the middle of the afternoon.
Are you busy?
Are you busy?
There's something I'd like to say to you.
Okay.
There are 3 different kinds of bees. The drones are worked in a single solitary queen. The workers are all women. Their job is to forage for honey, pollen, etc. Their lifespan is potentially anywhere between 5 weeks and 6 months, and then they die. Drones exist solely to have sex with the queen, and each hive tends to have around 100 drones. Once they've deposited their sperm, their penis gets ripped off and they die. Their lives are often intentionally short, but in a strange sort of way, I'm jealous of the humble honeybee and their quiet elegance. If only our existence were that simple. If only we could understand why it is we're here and what it is we're meant to spend our lives doing. I am uncertain when it comes to a great many things, but there is now one thing I'm defiantly certain of.
Oh, Roland, come on. Roland, come on, get out of here.
Marianne Lebel, will you marry me?
Roland. We talked about this. Come on.
All right.
Well, this is a surprise.
Is it?
Yeah, I mean, it's the middle of the afternoon.
There's something I'd like to say to you. Shit!
What is it?
Oh, I've left it at home.
Roland!
Okay, I'm just going to own up. I came down here because I had something to say to you, and I had this whole speech written out, and it took me a fucking age,
Roland.
And it's just thrown me a bit.
You're sweating.
There's something I'd like to say to you. So, as you know, well, I mean, maybe you know, there are 3 different kinds of bees.
There's the drones, there's the workers, and there's the queen. And the drones are all women.
No, the workers. The workers are all women.
The drones have sex with the queen, but once they've ejaculated, they die. I should have written this down.
What
I'm trying to say is that bees have a short life. They have an incredibly short life, and then that's it. The bit about the lifespan should have come at the start, and then I could have moved on to the
Roland, is there something wrong?
Do you remember when we first met?
Yeah.
You do?
Yes.
At that wedding?
What?
John and Ruth's wedding.
We met at a barbecue.
There are three different kinds of bees. The drones, the workers, and a single solitary queen. The workers are all women. Their job is to forage for honey, pollen, etc. Their lifespan is potentially anywhere between 5 weeks and 6 months. And then they die. Drones exist solely to have sex with the queen, and each hive tends to have around 100 drones. Once they've deposited their sperm, their penis gets ripped off and they die. Honeybees have an unfailing clarity of purpose. Their lives are often intensely short, but in a strange sort of way, I'm jealous of the humble honeybee and their quiet elegance. If only our existence were that simple. If only we could understand why it is that we're here and what it is we're meant to spend our lives doing. I am uncertain when it comes to a great many things. But there is now one thing I am defiantly certain of. Marianne Bell, will you marry me?
Okay.
Really?
Yeah, really. Where was that speech from? Was it from a book? It was, wasn't it?
Bits.
I got to do a fucking tutorial.
I'll see you at home.
Is that okay?
Of course.
Thank you.
If you're serious, you're right, then.
Meaning what?
Outline why they want to be taking you seriously.
And if they do?
You need some.
Out there or here?
Out there. You have to meet them a couple of times.
Always out there?
I think so.
Then what?
Then it's up to you.
How do they do it? How does it work?
They use something called a bug.
It's okay.
They mix it with water.
I don't really know what to say.
How bad is it?
It's pretty bad.
How bad is pretty bad?
They said being under 40 might help, but...
Mary, how bad is pretty bad?
I'm not sure I want to talk about it right away.
Mary, I've been waiting around on tenterhooks.
I'm not sure I can talk about it right away.
Well, would you want something to drink? Do you want some water?
No, thank you.
Would you want some booze?
Just after a moment's silence, and then I'll tell you anything you want. You said, I think it was something like a third. A third of people live for a year.
What about the other two?
What?
What about the other two thirds? How long do they live for?
I don't know, Roland. I don't know.
What did they say? What did they tell you?
I don't know. I can't remember. They gave me some leaf I mean, fuck me! Why does it matter what happens to the other two thirds?
Why does it matter?
Yes!
It matters because presumably we don't know which third you're going to be.
Why are you being arsey with me?
I'm not being arsey.
You are! You're getting mad at me for not remembering this number and that number. I mean, who gives a fuck?
Right.
I'll go upstairs and get my fucking handbag and you can rifle through the plethora of leaflets if it bothers you that fucking much!
Alright! Alright, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Did they talk about treatment?
They said they can operate. Try to remove it. Remove as much of it as they can. And then he suggested radiotherapy. But he said if I'm too weak for radiotherapy, then chemo. A shitload of chemo. It's right at the front.
The front?
It's all over the frontal lobe.
I don't know what that means.
He said I might have trouble selecting words, selecting the right words. He said I should expect seizures.
Jesus Christ.
It's palliative. Whatever they do, it's not. They
okay.
can't.
Okay.
He said this is it.
Okay.
This is it, he said.
Okay. Okay.
Why don't you sit down?
Oh, I need to sit down, do I?
No, I mean standing is fine.
I'd have come with you today if you told me.
I know.
I would have cancelled my...
I know I wanted to go alone.
I'm a bit angry, actually, Mary.
Angry?
I'm saying that so you know.
You're angry?
I'm saying that so you know because I don't want to have an argument.
Oh, I'm glad to fucking hear it.
All right.
I'm sorry that you missed out on the sheer joy that was collecting my biopsy results. But forgive me, I didn't feel like inviting along a fucking entourage of onlookers.
All right! Christ, I'm telling you so I can get it off my chest. Because I want to be as honest with you as I possibly can, because I don't know what you're about to say, but it's clearly bad news, and I want to be able to listen and not be wondering. I wonder what she did with herself when she heard.
Reason why.
I wonder why she didn't call me straight away.
I knew that you were going to be...
Because I would have cancelled absolutely everything and everything, and I wonder if she knows that.
So, I got my biopsy results.
Today?
They called me and they asked me to come in.
Who'd you see?
Dr. Thorpe.
And what did he say?
He said it's benign.
He said
that it's a grade one and he said that it's benign.
He said that.
He said that ordinarily with a grade one, we should expect to see a full recovery.
Did he use the phrase full recovery?
Exact quote. Ordinarily, we should expect to see a full recovery.
Fucking hell. What happened to that?
They need to operate.
But he definitely used the phrase full recovery.
He did.
Are you alright?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Do you want some of that bolognese? The homemade stuff?
Have we got any of that nice spaghetti?
I love you.
It's called a glioblastoma multiforme.
Right.
It's a grade 4.
Right.
It's at the front.
Okay.
He said that's the reason why I've been having troubles.
Speaking.
He said they should operate.
Well, great.
He said that's what they should start with.
Well, great.
And then he suggested radiotherapy. But he said if I'm too weak for radiotherapy...
Too weak?
Yes.
Okay, sorry.
He said that if I'm too weak for radiotherapy, then chemo's probably better. He said that...
Look, we can stop.
No, I'm okay.
We can eat.
No, I'm fine.
Honestly, we can stop.
I think I'd rather just get through it.
No, you're right.
It's a year.
A year?
Probably less.
Probably less than a year.
He didn't say that, but...
They didn't tell you that.
I went online.
But they didn't tell you that.
He said that we can talk about all that when next we meet, but when I got back to campus...
Mary...
No, it's stupid. I shouldn't have done it, but I went on a forum.
A forum?
People had left all these dedications to people they'd known that had died. There were pages and pages and pages of the stuff, and most of it was really wet and drippy, and it made me really fucking angry.
Angry?
There's so much bullshit.
You mean on the forums?
When somebody dies, there's so much bullshit.
Right.
I mean, when your time's up, your time's up. Time? I mean, what on earth are they even talking about?
We should eat.
She was a real fighter. Was she? Or she didn't do a very good fucking job of it, did she?
Right.
Some of them had uploaded photos. There was a photograph of a woman with God knows how many tubes hanging out of her. And she was surrounded by these garish fucking balloons.
Some people like to give balloons.
You give me a balloon and I will fucking garrot you.
No balloons.
And you put a photo of me on a fucking forum and I will haunt the shit out of you.
No forums. Let's see, we should get something to eat. Cancer. Tumor. Okay. It's at the front. Okay. It's why you've had trouble typing. I understand. The doctor thinks operation, great. Operation first, great. Radiotherapy. But if you're not strong enough for radiotherapy, then chemo. Chemo is better. 1 year. Less than 1 year. Less than 1 year of your life to live. What did the doctor say? Who said less than 1 year? A forum. Angry. Right. Some people like to give balloons. No balloons. No forums. We should eat. Let's get something to eat.
I think I'd like to go abroad.
What do you mean?
I'm not sure how much of a difference the humans really make.
Do you mean you're not sure or they're not sure?
I mean, I'm not sure.
Why? What aren't you sure about? Why aren't you sure?
It's scary. It's... I was coming home.
I was on the train, and I was coming home. A group of men got on. A group of 30-year-old men, they were pissed. I was sat at a table and I had my laptop out. They sat at my table and the table opposite. And they started winding me up. I put my laptop in my bag and I tried to move to a different seat, but they blocked me. They wouldn't let me pass. I couldn't speak. I couldn't find the right words. And they started laughing. They howled with laughter. I started to cry until finally one of them said, "That's enough."
You should have told me.
I went on to campus.
What do you mean? What
for? To have lunch with Melissa. I had a seizure.
What? When? Mary?
A couple of weeks ago.
A couple of weeks ago?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell me?
It's the words, Roland. It's becoming more and more tiring.
You mean speaking to me? The two of us is tiring? Or you mean everything?
I mean everything.
I didn't realise.
I know.
I'm sorry.
I know.
I don't know what to do.
You don't have to do anything.
I want to help.
You are.
So when you say abroad, you mean abroad and not come back?
Potentially. Yes.
How does it work?
You have to become a member.
A member?
Pay some money.
How much?
I don't know what it is in pounds.
And then what?
Well, then you have to meet with someone.
Out there or here?
Out there.
Always out there?
I think so.
Then what?
Well, then, if you're serious, you write to them.
Meaning what?
Outlining why they ought to be taking you seriously.
And if they do?
Well, then it's up to you, really.
How do they do it? How does it work?
They use something called a bar.
It's okay.
They mix it up with water.
I don't really know what to say.
You don't have to say anything.
No, I know, but I want to. I want to know what to say to you.
A lot of people apparently never go through with it.
What do you mean?
A lot of people, once they've been given the green light. Night. A lot of. They're happy enough knowing it's there.
How do you know that?
It's on the website.
When we say a lot, how many were we talking?
think it was something like 2/3 safety net for a lot of people.
Is that how you're feeling about it?
I don't know.
Would I be able to go with you?
I'm going to meet with Martin. I mean, do you want to come with me?
Do you want me to come with you?
Mum.
In what way?
Before she died.
Right.
When she said she didn't want any more food.
Yeah.
Do you remember?
I'm not sure we ever really talked.
I thought we did.
Bits and pieces, maybe.
Well, when she said she wanted them to stop the IV, did we talk about that?
Yeah.
They asked me to leave. I went back the next day. And she was starting to look like a ghost. It takes an enormous amount of strength when you're like that to keep going. I'm not sure I have it.
You don't know. Mary, you don't know that.
Sinking feeling.
Mary, listen to
me. I'm so tired, Roland. I'm so tired. Before I face. Fuck.
It's okay.
God.
God.
People's lives were their own before it became skin. Skin. It became...
skin.
Mum wasn't scared of dying. She was scared of being kept alive, you know?
Yeah.
It wasn't what scared her.
I understand.
It's not just the speaking.
Okay, now I don't understand.
Reading. I'm having trouble. Words, numbers on the page. I don't know how to explain it. Typing as well.
In what way?
I know the word I'm trying to type, but I don't know the letter. None of the letters seem right.
You don't need to finish.
I want to.
I think I know what you're trying to say.
Most of the time, I don't even know what I'm trying to say.
You're right. I was being polite because I don't want you to wear yourself out.
And maybe we should just get me a notepad to hang around my neck.
What?
Kidding.
Holy fucking hell.
Roland. I don't think I can go back to work.
Have they told you that?
They're great.
You've told them that?
Not yet.
But you're going to?
I think so.
But you haven't said any of this to them?
They said whatever I want.
So what about part-time?
I don't know the point.
The point of going part-time?
Well, either I'm walker. You know, I'm walking. Either do it or I don't. Scares me.
Work?
Stopping
work scares you?
I mean, what will I do?
We'll go away. We can do whatever we want. I'm being serious.
I don't.
No, I mean it.
We can't. I have to make up. I have to have a choice. Control.
Taxi's booked at 9.
I know.
Gives us an extra half an hour.
It does.
Are you tired?
A bit.
Do you want to go to sleep?
What time is it?
Are you cold?
No, I'm okay.
I can turn the air conditioning off.
No, I'm fine. I know.
And it gives us an extra half an hour.
It does.
Are you tired?
A bit.
Do you want to go to sleep?
What time is it?
Are you cold?
No, I'm okay.
I mean, I could turn the air conditioning off.
No, I'm fine.
Taxi's booked for 9.
I know.
Gives us an extra half an hour.
It does.
Are you tired?
A bit.
Do you want to go to sleep?
No, I'm okay.
Are you cold?
No, I'm fine.
I can turn the air conditioning off.
No, I'm okay.
Do you want me to put the telly on?
No, thank you.
Are you hungry?
Full.
I've had a really wonderful day.
Me too.
Really?
Yeah.
Can I be honest with you?
No.
There are times when I look at you and I absolutely understand why you're doing this. But there are times when I absolutely don't. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't be calling it a day. But I suppose I am starting to wonder if now is the right time. Because if it were me and I were you, I think I would want as much time as possible. And if you think you've got another couple of months in you, then God, I would love to give that a go.
Yes.
What?
Yes, let's go home.
Me and I were you, I think I would want as much time as possible. And if you think you've got another couple of weeks in you, then God, I would love to give that a go.
What do you mean by time?
Time? I mean time. I want more time with you.
I'm not sure that you and I, we might think that, but that there's an arrow from past to present.
Mary.
But that's all we really know. Asymmetrical.
Mary.
But nobody knows why.
Okay.
Listen to me, please.
Let's not talk about
please.
This now. I shouldn't have brought
Listen
it up.
Listen to me, please. The basic laws of physics don't have a past or a present. Time is irrelevant at the level of atoms and molecules. It's symmetrical. We have all the time we've always had. You still have all our time There's not going to be any more or less of it once I'm gone.
Hello, Marianne.
Roland!
Wow.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Great.
I'm good. I mean, I'm well.
Good.
I bought some of your honey.
Really?
Yeah, for the bludgeons and crouch heads.
Yeah, right. Great.
I said to the girl on the chill, I said I used to know the man who made this honey.
Well, what's she say?
She just stared at me.
I've read all your papers.
Wow. That's really amazing. Thank you.
Well, what did you think of the honey?
It was delicious. It was completely delicious. Are you here for the ball?
Yeah, I am. Yeah. Heather's getting married in a couple of months, so...
Oh, to the PE teacher?
That's right. Wow, good memory. I've been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else. How about you? Are you...
Oh, similarly. Wedding.
Oh. Your own or...?
God, no. Can you imagine? No, I'm being a very diligent bridesmaid. I'm having some kind of mass Vinny's waltz. I'm not sure I fully understand it yet.
So is this your first lesson?
No, second. How about you?
Yeah, first, yeah.
Well done on the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work last week. Crotch was like a fucking hothouse by the time I got home.
We should. Afterwards, if you, I mean, if we're not both completely exhausted, there's a nice place not far. We could try going for a drink. But if we're there and you change your mind, we'll call it a day. We'll just call it a day, and you'll never have to see me again.